The following is a fan-based parody. Sword Art Online is owned by A1 Pictures, Aniplex USA, and Lucky Kawahara. Please support the official release.
You just got my friend!
Sword Art Online. It's been a while since the beta. Wonder if they changed anything. Aw, oh, come on, really? That's just disgusting. Activate ad blocker. I am going to burn this f***er to the ground.
Oh, God!
Wow, congrats. You were defeated by a pig.
F*** you, man! That's like the pig from hell!
Really? My god! I've stumbled across the most powerful weapon in the game!
Stop.
The mithril pebble of pig smiting!
Please stop.
For you see, long ago, this pebble was forged in the fiery pits of Tartarus by the grand blacksmith of Lucifer himself, in a time before the world began. And thus, Mardoza, guardian of the pebble, fell to his knees and passed from this world, leaving behind the mighty weapon, for he knew that one day, its power would be required once more.
I have a feeling you get beat up a lot in real life.
Shut up! Here I have power!
You look so... young.
And you look less hairy, Balls.
My name is Klein.
No, it's not. Ballsy, I'm heading to the next town, and I need your help.
Really? You need my help?
Yeah, there's a mini-boss on the way, and I need some cannon fodder. You in or out?
As tempting as that sounds, you may be the most unbearable asshole I've ever met, but you are really good at this game.
Call me an asshole!
In a game of life or death, you either live or you die.
Oh, wow. What brilliant insight. It's so deep, it loops right back around to being stupid.
The kid ranted at no one. It's slowly dawning just how alone he truly was.
Wait, what was that?
He asked the sky like a preacher to his silent gods.
What gods? What are you talking about? It's all bullshit metaphors with you.
He cried, not knowing the difference between a simile and a metaphor. The tininess of his brain dwarfed only by the tininess of his dick.
Narrator off.
You can silence me, but you can't silence the truth.
Dick.
Now, it goes on to say when Ilfang's health goes into the red, he's going to switch from his axe and buckler to something called a Talwar. At that point, we should initiate a strategy called the Final Solution and I'm just gonna stop reading! Jesus, who wrote this thing? Let's hear some other suggestions!
I'd like to hear more about this Final Solution.
Fuck it, group up.
So, why aren't you joining anyone's group?
I have my reasons.
Is it because you're a girl?
No! It's because I don't know how to play.
Because you're a girl?
No! It's just, I don't know how to open the menu.
What? But you can't do anything in this game without the menu. How have you survived all month?
How do I eat you? It's been a challenge. What about you? Why haven't you joined the others?
Oh, lots of reasons. Mostly because they're a bunch of mouth-breathing neckbeards who think LMAO is how French people laugh.
That's so lamau.
Wow, you certainly speak from the heart.
Funny, I thought I was speaking from my mouth, but shows what I know about biology.
No one else wanted you in their group, did they? All right, Kirito, here's what we'll do. One counters his blows to knock him off balance, and the other switches into attack. Rinse, repeat, victory.
You came up with that, but you can't open a menu. Oh shit! Diabo, look out! That's not a Talwar! It's an Odachi!
What's the difference?
Well, a Talwar is of Indian descent, while an Odachi is Japanese. While both are primarily slashing weapons, a Talwar was favored by cavalrymen, as opposed to an Odachi, which was mainly used for dick measuring.
What's your point?
Well, if you let me finish, I was getting to that. You see? I was trying to say a Nodachi's a little bit longer than a Talwar, so it'll have more reach and do a bit more damage.
And why couldn't you say that first?
I like to think of myself as a teacher. Anyway, drink this.
No, it's better this way. I just can't do it anymore. I had such high hopes at first, but now Our best player is a girl who thinks DPS is some kind of sex thing.
I know, it's weird, right? Just take that little voice in your head that tells you to be tactful and understanding, and shoot it. Shoot it in the goddamn face.
You are so wise. If only I'd met you sooner, perhaps things would have been different. You must lead them now. Show them this game can be beaten.
In another life, in another time, I think we could have been friends.
I doubt it.
Well, fuck you too!
And because I know it's your day off, I went ahead and included a little motivation.
Right. Kata, when have you ever had anything I hate that goddamn hat! Yo, Sachi, Kata said you ran off or—
Jesus Christ, what's wrong with your eyes?
What? Oh, right, detective mode. One sec. Oh, that's brisk.
Is it supposed to hurt like that?
I don't think so. Unless the game is developed by a sadist.
Well...
Yeah, I heard it. So anyway, I figure I got about, 5 minutes before I black out from the pain. So princess, why'd you run off?
Because I'm terrified my leg is going to get me and everyone I love killed.
Well, shit, I don't know how to mock that. Oh god, that's never happened before!
Well, maybe this is something you don't need to mock.
Okay. But then what's the point of other people if not to mock them?
You know, I'm starting to see why people think you're an asshole.
People think I'm an asshole? Wow, Sachi, you've really opened my eyes. I've been such a jerk. Well, no more. You're looking at a whole new Kirito. From now on, I'm gonna be nicer and show people the compassion they deserve.
So can we talk about my problems now?
Ugh, no one cares.
Oh. Hey, I thought you said you were gonna black out from the pain.
Oh, yeah. Guess I'm just a lot tougher than I thought. Oh, wow. A single chest in an empty room. Yeah, this looks legit. Come on, guys. Even we're not dumb enough to fall for this. Sachi, you set them to auto-loot, didn't you?
Yeah, I thought it would save time.
Oh, yeah. We're sprinting to our deaths at record speed. Sachi, no!
Kirito, this isn't your fault.
What's wrong, little girl?
Well, I guess it all started when I was born. My mom was a bit of a drinker. But sober, that was just not in the cards. Then those gorillas showed up and attacked me. But thankfully, Hina stalled them long enough for you to save me. And then, you know the rest.
Kid, no language on Earth has a word for how little I care. A quantum supercomputer calculating for 1,000 years could not even approach the number of fucks I do not give. The friggin' heat death of the universe could not—
Are you gonna tell me or not?
Sure, whatever.
Kirito, how'd it go? Did you win?
Does this look like the face of victory to you?
You didn't get it?
Oh, I got it. It's a hat. It's a goddamn hat.
Well, what do you want to do with it?
Wear it, poop in it. I don't really care anymore. But I do suppose I should thank you. You made me realize that by being nice and letting people in, they'll just die. But even still, thank you for showing me that there's still a part of me that can feel like this. Because now that I know where to find it, I've killed it forever. So thank you. Thank you for freeing me. Balls.
Are you unharmed, my lady?
What?
I said, could you stop staring at me? It's creepy! Man, I thought we were done after that 7th boss, and then BAM! There's number 8!
I just wanna go home.
Wait, hold on, Silica. Do mine eyes deceive me? Tis the fabled word tree of Gamagorath, font of human knowledge, and devourer of souls. Quickly, child, we must spirit away before it— Oh my god, will you just come out already?
Ah, your detection skill must be quite high for you to have known I was here.
Rosalia? Oh my god, how are you? Oh god, wow, that's enough of that. Jesus, how do you put up that act all day?
Oh, so you saw through me, did you? You're quite a clever boy to have figured out that I'm actually the leader of Titan's Hand.
Hey, fuck that guy! Titan's hand? Wow, I thought you might be someone dangerous like Laughing Coffin. Never even heard of you.
Laugh all you like. We're still one of the most feared orange guilds on the lower floors.
Ooh, impressive. You can frighten players that think slimes are terrifying.
Have you seen their eyes? They have no souls!
So quick with the snark. Of course, that's all you really have going on, isn't it? A witty retort to distract everyone from what you really are. A sad, lonely little boy with no one who loves him. Someone so dead inside, he'd use a child as bait to lure me out.
Mr. Kirito would never do something so horrible.
Nah, she's right, I totally did that.
And to top it all off, you play the tough guy. This invincible warrior you can never hope to be in the real world. Getting stuck in this game was probably the best thing to ever happen to you. But there's one thing this game will never let you hide. The one thing that's haunted you your whole life that you can never escape. You sound like a girl.
What? No, I don't sound like a girl. That's crazy! That's crazy!
Well, it looks like my work here is done. I do so enjoy our chats, but I really must be off. We'll be taking the Numa flower now, if you don't mind.
Really? Little old you is going to take it from us? That'd be a neat trick.
Indeed, but a magician is nothing without her lovely assistants.
Oh no, Mr. Kirito! There's so many of them! I'll back you up!
Ah, that's adorable. You think they're a threat. Well, you just sit tight. Show's about to start. Careful, though. The first three rows are a splash zone.
What do you mean by that?
Boss, a thought occurs. This guy thought he was going up against Laughing Coffin, but he still just brought himself and a small child. You sure we want to mess with this guy?
Please, the boys all talk. And now that I've broken him, he's not even that anymore. He's nothing but a gibbering mess grasping at straws.
Ooh, another one of your famous theories. Tell you what, I'll give you the first shot. See how that goes.
Boss, I think this might be a trap.
Enough! You're all level 45, and there's 7 of you. I think you've got this. Now kill him!
Oh no! I knew it! Rosalia really got inside his head! He's not even fighting back! Well, I guess it's up to me to save him!
Wait, what?
Man, you guys are out of shape. Really ought to do some cardio.
What are you idiots doing? Quit screwing around and finish him!
I don't understand! We threw everything we had at him! How is he still standing?
How? Well, it's quite simple, really. You see, girly, you may think you got me all figured out, but there's one thing you didn't account for. My numbers are bigger than yours. Funny thing, really. Get to a high enough level and you're basically untouchable. My wounds heal faster than you can make them. We could do this all day, and you would not be any closer to beating me. Not that it wouldn't be fun. But I've got good news. You see, there's no need to wonder where your god is. Because he's right here! And he's fresh out of mercy.
Well, way to prove my point, kid! Lording your stats over them like some kind of god! Your strength is nothing but an illusion to cover!
I'm getting real tired of your first year psych student bullshit.
Enjoy this while you can. It's the deepest you'll ever be in a woman.
Santa Rosalia!
Oh, I love you too, Kirit.
Wait, what? Who the fuck is Rosalia?
Nobody had just slipped out. Wait, Austin, no, I get it. Whoa. We can't just go around sacrificing NPCs. Some of my best friends have been NPCs.
That makes way too much sense.
We must save my family.
You see? Some of them even have Gary. Excuse me. I have to go say hi to an old friend. It won't be a minute. Gary, long time no see!
We must save my-
Yeah! Bet you didn't expect to see me again, did you, Punk?
We must save my family!
You left us to die, you bastard!
We must save my
this is Versace! Choke on it! Choke on my vengeance! How does it taste?
Yeah, you know what? Maybe he has a point. This is super uncomfortable.
So, how's your day going? You're looking pretty relaxed there, buddy.
Pretty good. This grass feels amazing.
Cool. You want to know what I did today?
Not particularly, but I suspect that wasn't a real question.
I was fighting goddamn Sheep Tar! It was great! You should have been there! He was climbing the walls, spitting acid!
We're still talking about a sheep, right? Not like a fluffy xenomorph?
It's a really stupid boss!
Apparently not that stupid if it killed 7 of you.
12 now, actually.
Oh, well, that's a thing. But I mean, you survived, so hey, silver lining.
Okay, what the hell is wrong with you? You're way too... mellow.
Well, I had some time to kill before the raid, so I figured I'd power level my alchemy a bit by eating some weird plants. And now everything's... just great.
Oh my god. I can't believe this! You're the one that insisted we couldn't use the NPCs as bait! And then you go in!
Asna, look, okay? I get it. You had a really bad day. You're stressed out. 7 people died.
12 people!
Not the point. Look, they're dead now. And really? Whose fault is that?
Yours!
That's right. No one's. So why don't you lie down, relax, and watch the stars with me?
It's 2 in the afternoon! There are no stars!
Only if you're looking with your eyes.
What the hell does that mean?
Only one way to find out.
You better come down soon so I can kick your teeth in.
Hey, sleepyhead. How was your...
Ah! Tell me what you did right now, and you may live!
Hide your whiskers on your face!
What?
I drew cat whiskers on you because I thought it would be funny, and it was.
Is that all?
Yeah? You were asleep. What else would I have done?
I mean, you know, you could have, like, you want to get something to eat?
This coming from the guy who ate random plants off the ground.
Oh, really? Well, who's dumber? Me or the one who takes a nap next to some crazed drug fiend?
Need I remind you that you were that drug fiend?
I can't be held responsible for stoned Kirito. That guy's an idiot.
Are you kidding me? You're the same person!
Oh, looks like we are out of time. Hey, man, when you pop, could you try to send the candy over this way?
I'm gonna go cut him down, you jackass.
I'll save you a Kit Kat. Hey, anybody got like a 30-foot stick? I want to take a crack at this thing.
Please, help.
Oh, don't be such a drama queen. Asna's gonna have you down, eh? Huh. So did anyone see where the candy went, or...
For Christ's sake, Kirito, a man just died.
Hey, Thunderlion, how's it hanging?
Kirito? Well, if it isn't my least favorite customer.
Nah, you just say that because I'm not dumb enough to buy any of your crap.
Yeah, well, if there's one upside to being trapped with these idiots, it's that they'll buy pretty much anything. What's the matter with you? Why would you bring her here? I thought we were friends.
What? I don't understand. What's the problem?
Hey, T-Dog. What is up in this his house?
Yoko, why would Grimlock have wanted to make sweet love to your friend's chest with the business end of a broadsword?
Settle down, you two. I think we can safely assume a ghost is not the culprit here. Right, Kirito?
Of course not. Obviously, it was a hit by the mermaid mafia paid in leprechaun gold. But who was the puppet master? The unicorns? No, they've had a feud going with the mermaids for years. Huh? I advise on the suspect, pursuing on foot!
Kirito, wait!
Shit! Come on!
So, did you catch him?
No, he got away.
Really? I figured some random perp would be no match for the world's greatest detective. Oh, wait, no. That's Batman! And you're not Batman, are you? You will never be Batman.
Hey, fuck you! Figured the whole thing out hours ago.
You what? Yeah.
My sandwich. It was innocent.
Kirito, are you gonna...
Shh! I must grieve.
Hmm? Oh, what is it now?
Oh, thank goodness, we're... saved.
Yay?
Stupid horse, that entrance was almost perfect!
I thought you looked really cool, Kirito!
Don't patronize me, Yoga Pants!
Yoga Pants?
And who, pray tell, are you? What business do you have here?
Detective Kirito, Line Grad PD. I'm on the hunt for a serial killer, and these three are the only witnesses. I'm gonna need you gentlemen to put down your weapons.
I'm afraid that's impossible, officer. The Lord has ordered these sinners dead. In the form of a guy who paid us $50.
$50? Selling yourselves a bit cheap, don't you think? You guys provide an essential in-demand service, and you're definitely the leaders in your field. You're Laughing Coffin. I mean, you gotta cash in on that name recognition.
That's what I keep telling him. But the high-paying clients won't touch us. They take one look at Reverend Killjoy over here and think we're a bunch of crazy people.
Exactly. You could reach a much wider demo if you just tone down the religious theme. What you guys need is a total rebranding, ad campaign, PR blast. Get your faces out there. Let people know you're not just about the fire and brimstone. You are multifaceted, three-dimensional killing machines, and you have got a little something for everyone. Because contract killing is a beat we can all dance to. Huh. So I own you guys now. That's cool. Can't wait to tell Tiff about this.
Not to sound ungrateful, Kirito, but what are you doing here?
Why, Yoko, we've come this far. I wasn't about to miss the end game.
I'm sorry, what are you-
Well, you see, I suspected all along that Kynes' death was nothing more than a ruse. The safe zones surrounding the towns are an immutable law of this game. Even still, that light show you put on was quite convincing. So, I did a little digging, and lo and behold, turns out that 457 has this fascinating little glitch that swaps the boring old teleport animation for the snazzy death version. The real kicker? The glitch only works if the game thinks you're in freefall. Like, say, and I'm just spitballing here, you were to hang yourself from a bell tower, or perhaps take a swan dive out a window. Pair that with a well-hidden teleport crystal, and you'd have an instant recipe for mysterious death. Serves one per conspirator, may contain trace amounts of called it!
But like I said in the hotel room, a ghost wouldn't have to follow the rules of a game. How did you realize I was lying?
Ah, well, that part was quite simple. You see, I'm not an idiot.
Yeah, that'd do it.
Shut up, Kynes. I thought it was clever.
Of course, I do have some evidence, if you're into that sort of thing. After your quote-unquote death, I leapt out the window to give chase after your apparent killer. As I watched them get away, my first thought was, why would a ghost need a teleport crystal? My second thought was, oh shit, window.
Shit!
And with that, much like that window, the cracks in your facade started to form. Your reaction when I suggested Kynes faked his death, your barely hidden disdain for Schmidt, the stupid ghost thing, it all made sense. You and Kynes were in this together, and for whatever reason, you had decided to fake your deaths. Of the three members who voted to keep the item, that only left Schmidt. And since he obviously wasn't in on it, that little bit of Shakespeare must have been for his benefit.
But how could you know that? We could have been working with him to scare you off or something.
Right. As if anyone would let that moron in on a conspiracy. A friggin' landmine deals with pressure better than him and would kill fewer people.
Hey!
Wow. Okay, let me see if I got this. You killed your wife because she wouldn't get in the kitchen and make you a sandwich?
And what man would blame me? Kynes, Smith, you guys know what I'm talking about.
Don't talk to us, man.
I can't believe you. You had something special, something most people spend their whole lives looking for, and you just threw it away. And for what? A lousy meal? You never really loved her. You just wanted to possess her. You disgust me.
Kid, someday you'll understand what it's like to be in love.
You son of a-
Hold it, Kirito. I've got something I've been holding in for a while. Grimlock, that hat makes you look like a hipster!
No! No, it can't be true!
What? No! Bullshit! I had to go to a dark place to pull out that masterpiece. It was full of emotions that scare and confuse me. Now come on, get up! We're doing this again! And this time, you're not gonna fold just because that hat makes it look like John Lennon joined the Mafia!
Oh, God!
Thank you for freeing me. Now, my soul can finally-
Ah! I don't know! Just run! Run!
Oh my God!
Oh shit, I completely forgot!
Hmm? What is it, Kirito?
Damn it! I hope it's not too late.
What? Was there something we missed?
Boom! Kitty Toe is always right, Foundation. Grand reopening.
Leave the shop? Why would I do that? I mean, I meet so many nice people right here.
Hello? Is anyone here? Can I get some goddamn service?
See? I'm making new friends already!
You have exactly 30 seconds before I burn this place to the ground. 1, 2, 3... 28! 29!
Sorry, sir. Is there something I can help you with?
Finally. Is the blacksmith in? I need to make a custom order.
Yes, you're looking at her.
Ah, of course, my apologies. I should have instantly recognized your traditional blacksmithing hoop skirt. The frills are a dead giveaway. I need a sword that's as good or better than this one. I used to have one that fit the bill, but... Now I don't! And that is the end of that story.
Whoa, an elucidator? This is the gnarliest sword you can get from a monster drop.
I'm sorry, did you just say gnarliest?
Hold on a sec, I think I got just what you need.
Alright, lay it on me, Keanu.
This is the best sword I ever forged. My masterpiece.
I don't know. Is it rad enough for me? Is it a bad enough sword to rescue the president?
Damn Skippy! And it comes with Elizabeth quality guarantee!
Is that so? Well then, I suppose you won't mind if I take it for a test drive.
What do you mean by...
No! Oh, this is fun. Hey, hand me another one.
Wait, maybe I can still...
Oh, God. You're not gonna start crying, are you? I cannot deal with any more crying women in my life.
What the hell were you thinking?!
Okay, this is better, I guess.
That sword was my baby! Why would you do that?! Would you do that to someone else's baby?!
You mean would I slam a baby into another baby to test its durability? No, that's not something I would typically do.
You know what I mean, dickweed! Now get the hell out of my shop!
Oh yeah? What about the Lisbeth quality guarantee? I mean, imagine if word were to get out that you tried to pawn this dollar store crap off on me like it was top tier loot. I mean, I could have been killed.
Yeah, wouldn't that have been a shame? What are you driving at?
Hey, I'm a reasonable man. Just make me the best sword in the game, or I'll do everything in my power to destroy your hopes and dreams.
What happened to as good or better?
Yeah, that was before you tried to sell me that embarrassment you call a sword. Prices just went up. Think of it as the Lisbeth quality guarantee plus interest.
Fine! You want the best sword in the game? I'll forge the best damn sword you've ever seen! I'll just need you to go gather a certain ultra-rare metal for me.
Alright, just tell me where to find it. I'll make a milk run.
Oh, don't think it'll be that easy. It's hidden in the mountains of floor 55, guarded by a level 99 elite dragon.
Ooh, scary.
And good luck even finding it, because the metal won't even spawn unless you're partied with a master blacksmith. Oh no. Then why aren't you cold, smartass?
Well, you see, I equipped this great new mountaineering item called pants! Really, it's astounding what science can do these days.
Oh yeah, real help-
I'm sorry, am I the only one in this damn game who understands how aggro works?
Look out! It's a breath attack!
What?
Kirito! Oh, thank God! I thought you were toast! Why didn't you dodge it?
Oddly enough, I was a bit distracted.
Really? I want breath attack!
What? No! Sorry about this, Mr. Dragon. This isn't really about you, but I need to blow off some steam!
Yeah! You got it on the roof!
Aw, come on!
What? What's the big... Oh, no.
Damn it, Liz! You had one job!
Holy crap, he might actually... Oh, never mind.
Were the sound effects really necessary, Kaiba?
I'll fucking do it again.
The fuck you! Don't say another word. You will never guess what this stuff is.
Hmm? What?
It's dragon poop. Liz! Liz, grab the crystal! Grab the crystal, Liz! Grab the crystal! Grab! K-
God, what is it with you women and crying under bridges? You're like trolls.
Oh, Kirito, you're such a charmer.
Eh, I do my best.
That's sad.
What?
Forget it. How did you even find me anyway? Yeah, that makes sense.
Look, I don't know what Asuna said to you, but I'm guessing it was pretty messed up and possibly, probably, racist. What race gives you pink hair and freckles anyway? Did, like, your Irish dad get his dick stuck in a cotton candy machine? Truly, theirs was a love that can never be. I'd see that movie. Sorry, what was I talking about?
You were apologizing?
That doesn't sound like me. Right, the sword. I named it.
Oh, so what did you decide on?
Well, after what we've been through, I figured only one name seemed appropriate. Sunlight Heart.
Oh, Kirito, that's beautiful.
Thankfully, I came up with a much better name. I called it the piece of shit. ... Dragon shit, that is. LOL, trademark Lisbeth. And then followed by, like, all your contact info. Hey, how could I pass up the opportunity to cement your legacy? I mean, just think. From now on, whenever someone makes a dragon poop sword, you know what they're gonna think? Lisbeth.
How the hell did you get your hands on an S-class ingredient?
Oh, Diff, let me tell you a tale. I don't have anything for this. I threw a knife at it and it died.
You disappoint me, man.
I disappoint myself.
So, you gonna put your sword away before dinner?
Shit, you can see that? It's not his fault he looks like Voldemort got caught in a grease fire.
Wait, what?
I wonder what exactly makes it S-class. My God! It's beautiful! It is too early. Hey, Asuna. How are you this Oh, shit. Well, I'm awake. Really? You need me to save you from this half-melted troll doll?
He broke into my house and was watching me sleep!
Wait, what?
Well, if you're careless enough to let a cretin like him into your home, then clearly you can't be trusted to be out of my sight.
You were watching us?
Hey, Skeletor, bit of career advice. Maybe don't treat your boss like she's a toddler playing in traffic. She can take care of herself just fine.
What did you call me?
Oh, not a fan of that one? I have others. How about... You look like Benjamin Button fucked an old catcher's mitt, like 4 inches of face stretched over 12 inches of skull. Like a moldy jack-o'-lantern some frat guy barfed in and then crushed against his forehead because he was super drunk, thought it was a beer can, and immediately regretted every single life choice he ever made.
Enough! How dare you mock me in such a manner?
Well, how would you like me to mock you then? I take requests. Okay, Elephant Man, why don't you take your bony ass back through that teleporter before I make your face look even worse? I mean, jeez, you already look like Jeff Goldblum.
That last one didn't sound like an insult.
In the fly.
Fuck you and do me!
Ah, you are too easy. Eat tadakimasu!
Asuna, I promise I won't be mad. Just tell me what you did to the sandwich.
What are you talking about? I didn't do anything to it.
Then why does it taste like you dipped a dog turd in Cool Ranch? My God. We flowers for Algernon to our taste buds! Wow, I guess you could really say he went out on a high note.
Really, man? A pun?
What? What's wrong? I'm a funny guy. It's what I do.
Someone help me, please!
I mean, what do you expect from me? It's not like I care about any of this.
Please, I don't want to die!
I mean, why would I care? I shouldn't care. I don't care!
No!
Wait, when did he...
Why am I doing this? It makes no sense! I don't even know these people! Why am I fighting a giant fucking goat demon for them?
Gloria, my darling, is that you?
Kiss me and I drop you.
This is stupid! Why should I care what happens to any of them? They're all just a bunch of stupid sheep that let Korriban turn them off a cliff! They knew exactly what they were walking into. Which just begs the question, why am I still here?! Switch!
Okay.
All right, ugly. Let me teach you why they call me the legendary fuck!
Ready!
Holy shit!
Exclamation mark!
You know something? I really hate people. They're selfish, ignorant, loud, obnoxious pricks with basically no redeeming qualities whatsoever! I mean, really, look at all they've achieved! Genocide, global warming, reality TV, it's just a never-ending parade of failures and fuck-ups! They are, without question, a complete write-off of a species, and how dare you make me care about them! Everyone's safe. Now you can all go die for all I care. Whoa! What the fuck is he doing here?
Huh?
Aww.
Don Fluffles, you son of a bitch. How are you still alive? I saw you go over that cliff. No one could have survived that fall. You sly bastard. I would have never thought of that.
I'm sorry. Could he actually speak cat, or is he just messing with us?
Knowing him, it may very well be both.
You know, I still have that dagger you put in me. I've been meaning to give it back.
Gentlemen, you can't fight in here! This is the war room!
Laughing Coffin? I thought most of you guys were in prison these days.
Yes, it is true. The mighty guild that once struck terror through the hearts of all is no more. All because of this!
Boss won't get off your back? Girlfriend won't stop nagging you? Did that fuck stick Tiffany sell you a bullshit dagger that broke almost immediately despite the fact you spent half your goddamn coal on it? Have you considered murder?
Oh yeah, I remember that. Still can't believe they took my advice.
If only I could have met them in their prime.
Wait, you've never met them? I thought you said... Oh my god. You're not a member. You're a fanboy! That's amazing!
You made them sell out! And what did it get them? An army at their door and a blade mm-hmm. through their hearts? It used to be about the murder, you know?
Oh, let me guess. You prefer their early work.
And what of it?
This is the greatest day of my life.
Do you mind? I am trying to kill you!
That was amazing, Kirito.
Well, at least one of us enjoyed ourselves.
Excuse me?
Sorry, I can't turn it off. I'm broken. Please fix me.
Wow, that was almost kind of romantic.
Dude, what are you doing? We're blowing this. What were we supposed to say? We don't even know what made her like us in the first place. Fine. Just calm down. The hard part's over. As long as she doesn't throw us any curveballs, I think we're good.
So, what should we do now?
Fuck! What the hell is she talking about? What comes after sex? I don't know! All the dating sims just go to credits at this point. Well, she asked us a question, sir. We have to say something! Look, just say anything.
Anything?
Anything! Just say it with confidence. Alright, here goes nothing. You guys were the best slaves a boy could have.
Fuck it, I tried. You all saw it.
No! What? You said say anything! Anything except that, obviously! I'm sorry, I don't work well under pressure! You know what? It's fine, forget it. We'll just play it off as a joke. No harm done.
Yes, let's do it.
You fool! You don't got all! Hey, she seems pretty happy about it. Maybe she knows something we don't.
Bitch, why the fuck did you say yes?
I don't know!
Oh, I see. So you need me at the table, cracking jokes and breaking the ice. I gotcha.
No! God, no! I need to hide you under the biggest rock I can find!
I love you so much, I don't even know your real name. This peace talk, which was held in a dungeon. Look, lady, I was all for having a nice family adventure, but as our daughter so eloquently put it, that dumbass really should have seen this coming. And besides, this is the first floor. Can't be that hard to get to him. Heck, I bet even Freckles over here could get the job done. What do you say, Freckles? Up for a fetch quest? I feel like I'm the only one here who hasn't threatened to stab someone today.
I have not threatened anyone, Papa.
Oh, yeah. Looks like you and I are the only sane ones here, sweetie.
Yeah, Mama's scary.
Scary? Where? I'll kill him! I'll fucking kill him!
Is he gonna be alright?
Just let him work it out of his system. He'll tire himself out eventually.
Gee, thanks for the heads up on this guy, Thinker! Would it have killed you to send a quick, yo, trapped in a dungeon? P.S. You might want to keep your eyes peeled for the personification of death itself!
Yes, that did occur to me. But sadly, Kiba informed me that the messenger doesn't work down here. Or reception and whatnot.
And you believed him? Of course you believed him. You're stupid enough to be in this situation after all. Hey, come on out to my tea party in the middle of this minefield. Aw, don't mind the razor wire. We have crumpets! The power of love is bullshit. Power of swords and violence. That's where the money is.
So, I imagine you have some questions.
Yeah, maybe a couple. First and foremost, what happened to your sweater, young lady? God damn it, Kayabu! I am sick and tired of you kicking my heart in the dick! Well, not this time. Prepare to feel the wrath of a pissed off nerd with admin privileges!
You've led us to victory, Kirito. These men and I will follow you to hell itself. Now, address your people.
I always knew this day would come. Ahem. Fellow gamers, we have traveled far and up many stairs to get to this point, fighting side by side, noobs and elites alike. I'd like to take a moment to say that I couldn't have done it without the help of each and every one of you.
Oh, that's a nice thing to say.
Of course, I'm not a liar, so I'm not gonna say any of that.
Oh, shit.
I mean, really, I could have done this whole boss fight myself. But to be fair, I guess you did absorb a bit of damage for me, which was nice. You were an adequate meat shield, and no one can ever take that away from you.
Fuck, shut up!
So, for those of you who came in late, and that one guy playing Bejeweled back there, shoot for the stars. It'll make it more fun when I kick you back into the dirt.
You're not better than us!
My sweet-ass coat begs to differ.
Damn it, he's got us there.
Kirito, wait! I want half.
I'm sorry, what?
I want half the coat. I did half the work. I should get half the coat.
No! It's not fabric I can cut. It's a bunch of ones and zeros.
Fine, then give me the ones.
Fuck you, I want the ones. Ugh, I am not having this argument. I'm dissolving this party.
Kirito, if you walk away with my half of the coat, I will make your life a living hell!
You know what? Fine, I'll give you the damn coat. Just send me a trade request.
A what?
Oh, it's quite simple, really. Just open your menu.
You son of a bitch!
What if they actually do chop off my limbs, rip out my intestines, and ride me like some sort of meat toboggan?
You hear that, Asuna? Meat toboggan. Try getting that image out of your head. Gripping his entrails like the reins of Santa's sleigh, streaking through the fresh morning snow on a trail of bile and gore, as his eyes beg the same question as the horrified children in his wake. Why?
And there, under that frosted fir tree, Kirito spotted the big man himself, streaking through the snowy sky on a sleigh full of Christmas cheer. The patron saint of prostitutes!
Look it up.
Old Saint Nick.
Naughty. What the fuck?
Are you done?
Yes. But the legacy of the pebble lives on.